Okay, I ordered this Aqua Ionizer 7.0 from Amazon just yesterday. It was about $900, and it's here today. Amazon never ceases to amaze me. So let's open this box up. Quite a box this comes in. The handle on it and everything. See if I still have that in the frame. Yeah, somewhat. Okay. So let's open this up. One thing I wish these companies would learn a little bit from Apple about boxing. They never learn. They tape the heck out of these things, make it very difficult to get into the box without damaging the packaging. With Apple products, you can always open them without all of these issues. Okay. Seems like it's protected in here pretty good. There's some water lines. Let's see if you see that. Some water lines that came with it. I'm going to also videotape the setup process. Right now, we're just getting it out of the box. Trying to get it out of the box. It's all wrapped up. It's not super heavy, but it's pretty solid feeling. I mean, it's not light by any means. Seems like it's pretty well made. See if we can get this so you can see it. Water Ionizer model AJL-1166, 120 volts, 60 hertz, 120 volts. Hydraulic pressure, it's got a measure there, water flow. Made in China. But you know, that's not a big a factor anymore. A lot of these manufacturers, they have really good quality control in China. The Kangen water filters are made in Japan and are very expensive. This is a competitor that claims that it's as good or better for a much lower price. I'm going to try it out and we will see how well it works. So next videos you'll see is me setting this thing up. Okay, so I'm going to install this unit in my guest bathroom. Because it'll be out of the way and it'll be able to be used very easily to get water, but it won't be taking up space in the kitchen. And I don't use this guest bathroom that often to where it's going to be in the way here. I guess that's the filter, inner filter. Just kind of unboxing these things here as I go to see what components. And they got everything taped up here. These look like all the adapters to hook it up to the water. So it looks like there's some kind of a testing kit in here. I have not, see if those are in the frame of the camera. Oh, just barely in the frame. I should probably point this down a little bit, so you won't be able to see the top of the unit, but at least you can see more of the components. So, bunch of components here. So I'm probably, this looks like some kind of a testing kit. I might have to resort to reading some instructions. It's supposed to be pretty easy to install. I don't know what that's for. Looks like that's for mounting it to the wall. I guess you can hang it on the wall. I'm not going to do that because I'm going to be moving this back and forth between here and Florida, and also using it in my bus. So it's going to need to be fairly portable for me. But you can also permanently install these under a sink. A lot of different options. So I'm going to read a little bit about installation, and then I'm going to get started right now, and I'll restart the camera. Okay, so they say the first step is to identify the adapter. So I'm going to take off the water strainer here. Okay. All right, and then I'm going to try to determine which adapter I need to use to hook up this piece. It's probably just going to be this. Let's see here. Not sure. Okay, so of the several options they gave me, I had to end up going with the option where it uses these three screws, three Phillips head screws, to attach to the outside of the delta faucet head, and it seems to work, so that's attached on there nice and secure. So now I'm going to go on to the next step of the installation. Okay, so the next step is installing the inner carbon filter. So I'm going to take this off. Okay. The reason I'm doing this video is they say everything is simple, but they don't have any video showing all of this. So let's see. And unscrew this, I guess. And after unpacking new inner carbon filter, hold the end with the sealing ring on it under a running tap of water for 3 minutes. Okay, so I'm going to go do that in the kitchen. I'm going to run some water through this for 3 minutes, and then I'll be back. Okay, so I ran water through there for about 3 minutes. I've now pushed the filter down into here. You see this part is up. And they do mention that there's some other steps that I have to do to make sure that this thing is prepped to work. By the way, they say this is simple installation. I would not say it's simple. I'd say it's doable. I wouldn't use the word simple. At least it's not simple for me. I'm reading this. There's a lot of instructions here, a lot of cautions, a lot of warnings. So you can do it, but take your time and follow all the instructions. So I'm going to read a little more here, and then I'm going to do the next step. Okay, so evidently this little jumper that comes on here, that needs to be removed. There's little clips here that you remove. And you can then, let's see here. Maybe I can just pop those off with my hand. Try that first. Almost. I need a little tiny screwdriver is what I really need. Let's see here. Maybe this will pop it off of there. Whoops. Whoa, almost went down the drain. Oh boy. Cautionary tale. Make sure your drain is closed if you're doing this near a drain. Ooh, almost lost that clip. That would have not been good. Okay, because I don't see any extras around here. So I'm going to pop off this clip there. All right, so I got those two little clips off. Now I'll pull this out. I got to read about that a little bit more, how I pull those out. Talks about putting them in, it doesn't talk about pulling them out. So I'm going to need to read a little bit more here. Okay, so there's a little piece of plastic here that you push in a little bit, and then you can pull that right out. So you push that in, and that comes right out. And we're supposed to remove this and save it. I don't know what we're keeping it for, maybe when you're transporting the unit. Put that off to the side. And then I'm going to have to put the new lines on here. So I'm going to have to cut a couple of those. So let me do that. Okay, so I just used a sharp knife to cut this water line, cut a short piece. Well, that's probably about 14 inches or so to use for the drain line. Forget what they refer to it as here. And then another one's going to be the water line. So take a look here, what I need to do next. Okay, so I'm going to put the outlet hose in first. And that just, it just slips right in here. I guess that's all the way in. And then a little clip goes on. We'll find out when it either leaks or doesn't leak. It does not spin around. Okay, so that's the outlet. And then I need, this is going to be the feeder line to feed to it. So it's going to go around behind like this. Actually, no, I'll just have it run right over like this. So I guess this just pressure fits on here. Oh, I'm going to run it under some hot water to warm it up so I can slip it on there better. So I'm going to go do that in the kitchen. I'll be right back. Okay, so I ran that under the hot water a little bit. Let's see if we can get this to slip on here. Yep. Yep, went all the way on. Not easy, but it went on. Okay, so now I guess this will go under this side of it, and this side. And then it's not real flexible, by the way, this piping. So I'm going to put it like this, and then I'm going to put it in here. Okay, it's in. Doesn't snap in or anything. I'll be amazed if this does not leak. I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, so and this little snap in here. All right, so those are hooked up. So I should be able to set it up on the counter here. That one could have been longer. Well, guess what? It can come out right underneath. Yeah, that's better. That's better. Come out just like that. For that one. This can come out here. Actually, that can come out the other side. Come out
hide that a little bit. Am I still rolling?
Yeah, I'm still recording. Okay.
That's all right. What the heck? All right, so I'm about to fire this thing up for the first time. I'll hide the cord and do all of that. I'm sure this thing works. So I'm going to read a little bit more instructions before I plug it in. Put this cover back on. Actually, I'm going to leave that off until I get everything working. Oh, I need to install this too. Okay, so I'm going to pause one more time. So I'm supposed to put water through it now and see if it leaks. So okay, so I guess I'm supposed to do this before I turn the unit on. So make sure it's always on cold water. Okay, now I'm going to divert the water. Okay, the water's going through the unit out and I'm leaking. Let's see where I'm leaking from. I'm leaking from, whoops, damn, I would have gone all over the place. Okay, now it's not leaking much. Okay, one thing I gotta do is turn the pressure down a little bit here. Made a little bit of a mess. So you live and you learn. Don't have your documentation near the device, but no big deal. Okay, so it's running and I do have leaks. I'm gonna find where. Basically everything's leaking. Okay, so turn it down. Obviously I didn't get those hoses installed properly, so I got to research that a little bit and figure out what I did wrong. Okay, one thing I noticed right off the bat is I didn't push these lines hard enough to get them to snap in. You really have to push them. And that's not in yet. Don't know if that's in. There, finally snapped in. It really is not easy. You got to push those things and get them to snap in. That's something they should make more clear in the instructions. I thought that it didn't feel like it had a good connection before. I didn't know you had to push that hard. Okay, now I got the clips in. Okay, so those are in now. I'm going to read a little more and then I'm going to test it again. And in their defense, they do say firmly push. They do say firmly push, and I just wasn't pushing firm enough. So I would say very firmly push, and you'll feel it really snap in, and that'll be your indicator. Okay, so we're going to test it again here in a moment. Okay, I have it running now, and it is apparently not leaking this time. Hard to tell for sure because there's still some water around here, but don't see any fresh water coming out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to clean up all the water and test it again. Make sure that there's no new water coming out. Okay, so now I'm going to screw the, this screws in. Does this rubber come out? Doesn't say in the instructions. Screw the flexible metal spout clockwise into the outlet connector. So this is the kind of thing where these guys that write instructions, obviously you've never put one of these together. Do I take this rubber piece out or not in order to do that? It seems like to me, like, there's no way I can do it without taking that out. So I'm going to try to take it out there. Now, they might say, well, that's obvious that you have to take that out, right? But why don't they say it? Okay, so here we go. I'm going to put this in here. Screw it in. They gotta figure that people are idiots doing this stuff. They should tell them every step. I know I'm an idiot. And unfortunately, I think that's typical. Okay, so there we go. Now, I'm gonna turn the water on one more time here. See what happens. And it says daily drinking. I guess that's the default. Fine, I guess it's working. Oh, it's working. And see, the other water's coming out here. Interesting. So, water's coming out of both the drinking one. That would be where I'd fill up my drinking water. And here, I guess this would be cleaning water. I gotta read some more on the instructions a little bit. But pretty cool. It's sort of like a little video game going on there. Let me get the camera closer so you can see that better. Okay, now I'm doing this handheld, so it's going to be shaky, but I'm going to turn the unit on. Well, the unit is already on, plugged in and on. I'm going to turn the water on so you can see what happens when you turn the water on. See, the screen goes on. It tells you what it's doing. And then I could make various selections there, different options of what to do. But you see it automatically is working. There's water coming out of the drinking water spout, and there's water coming out of the other spout here. Okay. It's a little while for that thing to focus in, doesn't it? There it is running, and apparently no more leaking, at least for now. So I'm going to use this for about a week or so, and then I'll do a follow-up report on this. I'll put it this way. I'll report if there are any issues. If things don't work the way I'm anticipating they will work, I'll report on that. Anyway, thanks for watching.